Okay, so update on where I am currently with prep. I'm feeling okay. I would say this is the first week where I'm feeling pretty hungry.
I do my best to find some kind of glow. I'm giving it some heart and soul now. From the darkest grays, the sun bursts, clouds break. Yeah, we see that fire from the
sun. I mean, I'm eating, but I'm getting hungry a lot faster after my meals, and I'm getting, I kind of get like irritable. It's just part of prep and part of, I guess, the lean, getting lean process, but it lets me know that I'm getting closer to my goal, and I'm feeling, physique wise, I'm feeling really great. I feel like I'm progressing well, and my coach Paul seems, to be happy with my progress. So this past week at check-ins, on Saturday, which is the pictures of my progress, he lowered my carbs by 25, I think, and upped my cardio by 10 minutes each session. Currently, I'm doing 6 days of cardio at 40 minutes now. And then my macros were with the picture of my progress. So I'm feeling, you know, 125 carbs a day might sound like a lot, but for me personally, in my off season, I'm doing 300 carbs a day with free meals. So 125 consistently every day has me tired and hungry and irritable. And thank goodness, my husband is super, he understands. He knows, you know, if he can help around the house or whatever he needs to do to kind of relieve my anxiety and my, hangriness. He's really good about doing that. And honestly, since I've had my daughter, like, there is nothing that snuggles from a two-year-old can't solve. Like, so that's, you know, for me, that gets me through prep. So soon I'm going to announce what show I'm doing and how many weeks out. It just kind of helps me with my, with anxiety wise and expectations and pressure. I feel like not saying what show I'm doing has actually really helped me take some of that pressure off and just have a better prep overall. So I will talk soon about what show I'm doing. It's getting close. It's gonna be the first couple months of 2019. And then I have kind of a plan, as long as I can keep going with prep and everything's going well, I kind of have a plan of some national shows. So anyway, thanks for tuning in to the update. And then right after this, I'm gonna give you a little tour of our over 100-year-old home that we are redoing. To the road that we've been on now, the kaleidoscope claims another. Alright, so all of the drywall, prime, and insulation is done. In this room, they did the ceiling as well with some drop lighting. Is that what it's called? Drop lighting? Recess lights. Here is the banister that will never be stripped. I hear you, baby. We've been working on this since day one. The stairs, we took the carpet off. And I'll do white backings and keep the original flooring for these. Are you having fun?
Every day.
Every day. You heard that. Every day. So this hallway was completely re-drywalled. Ceiling and walls. In here, this is a bedroom. There used to be a door there that went up to the attic, so he sealed that off. The light switch was actually on the, it was really weird. It was on the opposite. Well, you can't see. The light switch was there for some weird reason, so now he put it where it belongs. And then in here, that was the other, there were like two entries into this bathroom. So he drywalled that off. So this is the other bathroom. And then, so that was that other bathroom. And then we added, this was a very, very small bedroom that we didn't really use for anything. So we put in a new window. And they did all the plumbing. And this is just kind of a work in progress here. But this will be another bathroom. So it'll be a 4-bedroom, 3.5-bath. Woo woo! When we get finished. And we didn't change anything with this room. This is just one of the other bedrooms. He did have to, and this one too, I don't know if it's the year of the house or what, but the light switches were on the wrong side. So he did switch that, but all the doors have really, they have the really cool original. I've always thought that was like really, really cool. And then also the hinges are all these original really cool hinges. So just to kind of show, because I'll do a really cool after, this is the master bedroom. Since we've owned it, we've changed it, but we're not changing it during this renovation. So we put in these really cool sconces. We put in an electric fireplace, and then he redid the tile work. We put in the carpet. And then that's a really cool, that's a turret. This is where we had our bed. So yeah, the master in this house is very large. So that's the master. And then that door is a bathroom for the master bath. Hi, honey. Do you run this place? So everything's really dirty from the renovations, but this is the master bathroom, and it has a walk-in closet, and we are going to redo this, I think. We haven't really decided. We'll at least repaint it. I don't know further than that what we'll do. So in that first bedroom, that's the wall that we blocked off. It's the entrance to the attic, but there's an entrance from the master bedroom is how you get up here. And eventually, if we stay, we'll flip those stairs so that you can get up here from the hallway instead of going through the master. But yeah, this is just kind of a, I thought it would actually be a really cool walk-up closet. Okay, so like I said, everything's very, very dirty, but this is the kitchen. We did not do anything to this as it was already finished. We are gonna change the window. It's like a weird shutter thing that we don't like. So there's that. And then over here is the other half bath. Nothing special, just half bath. And then I'm gonna take this out, but this is a laundry room. So yeah, that's the house.
The black Look at you! Free,
the like Kleenex. The queen
to the rook, your decision was a sure thing. Honey, yeah, a sure thing. No wonder I feel